Good afternoon, and welcome to our January Mid-Week Recital. I'm Dr. James Smith, Director of Music here at First United Methodist Church of Santa Monica. The biographical information and the program for today can be found on the church's website, santamonicaumc.org. Today we're featuring our organist and two very fine musicians who often come here and play in concerts that we do. So would you welcome with me Ty Woodward, organ, and David Searfoss and Stephen Billington, trumpets.
John Stanley was born in London in 1712 and at age 17 became the youngest person ever to obtain the Bachelor of Music degree at the University of Oxford. In 1734, he was appointed organist at the Temple Church in London, where his brilliant organ playing attracted the attention of many fine musicians, including George Frederick Handel, who regularly visited the church to hear him. Stanley was virtually blind following an accident at age 2, but had a remarkable memory, which helped him conduct many of Handel's oratorios and enjoy music making with his many friends. If he had to accompany a new oratorio, he would ask his sister-in-law to play it through just one time, which was enough for him to commit it to memory. John Stanley's compositions include an opera, cantatas, oratorios, and 3 volumes of voluntaries, which were written for organ, utilizing the trumpet stop, hence the term trumpet voluntary. The arrangement of John Stanley's trumpet voluntary in D for today's trumpet and organ recital does not use the trumpet on the organ, but features Stephen Billington playing the piccolo trumpet.
Thank you.
The next two pieces are by Johann Sebastian Bach. Each result in a completely different emotional experience. The first piece is from the Orgelbuchlein, the little organ book, a set of 46 compositions where in each setting, Bach takes the Lutheran chorale, adds a motivic accompaniment to the cantus firmus or melody. Sometimes the melody is straightforward, and in others, as is in the one I'm about to play, Bach adds numerous ornaments to the melody to help elaborate the text. One translation of the text for this chorale prelude is, "When in the hour of utmost need, we know not where to look for aid. When days and nights of anxious thought, nor help nor counsel yet have brought." Following that very short chorale prelude, we don't want to leave anyone in the depths of despair, and we'll go immediately into our second Bach piece with a completely opposite style. From Bach's cantata number 146 for Easter, "My Spirit Be Joyful," this arrangement is for two trumpets and organ, and demonstrates through Bach's compositional style how the sorrow of death has been completely superseded by the joy of the resurrection.
Thank you.
Alan Hovhaness was an American composer who died in the year 2000, having composed numerous symphonies, three ballets, and many other works. In the 1940s, he was organist at St. James Armenian Apostolic Church in Watertown, Massachusetts, a position he held for about 10 years. During this period, he devoted himself to using modes distinctive to Armenian music and achieved some renown and support of other musicians, including the radical experimentalist composer John Cage and choreographer Martha Graham, all while continuing as a church organist. In the early 1960s, about the time this sonata for trumpet and organ was written, he conducted a series of research trips to India, Hawaii, Japan, and South Korea, investigating the ancient traditional music of these nations and eventually integrating elements of these into his own compositions. In 1965, as part of a U.S. government-sponsored delegation, he visited Russia as well as Soviet-controlled Georgia and Armenia. While there, he donated his handwritten manuscripts of harmonized Armenian liturgical music to the State Museum of Arts and Literature. Next, we feature David Searfoss playing the first movement of Hovhaness's Sonata for Trumpet and Organ.
Thank you.
Jean Alain was a French composer born into a family of musicians. His father was an organist, composer, and organ builder. His younger brother, a composer, organist, and pianist. And his youngest sister was the famous organist Marie-Claire Alain. His short career as a composer began at age 18 and was influenced by the musical language of Claude Debussy and Olivier Messiaen, as well as his interest in music, dance, and philosophy of the Far East, a renaissance of Baroque music and also jazz. He was killed at the young age of 29 in World War II. His most famous work, titled Litanies, was composed in 1937. A litany is a form of prayer consisting of a series of invocations, each followed by an unvarying response. In his composition, Alain uses a repeated musical motif to represent the repeated response. Alain prefaced the composition with this text: "When in distress, the Christian soul can find no more words to invoke God's mercy. It repeats endlessly the same litany. For reason has reached its limit. Only faith can take one further."
Thank you.
composer of our final piece on today's program is June Nixon, one of Australia's best-known organists, choir trainers, and composers. She was appointed organist and director of music at St. Paul's Cathedral in Melbourne in 1973 and remained there for 40 years. She was recently commissioned by the American Guild of Organists to compose a piece for their 2020 National Convention, and the result is her entrata for two trumpets and organ based on the hymn, O God Our Help in Ages Past. She has an amazing sense of humor, which is quite evident throughout this composition, which includes several sprinkles of well-known patriotic tunes.